I'd much rather have these citizen developers building a part of the automation as opposed to not being involved at all. A co-development model is defined as a partnership for development, where we have a citizen developer working closely with a team or an individual IT developer who has some bot building experience. And that co-development allows those two resources to work together so that if my citizen developer is good for, let's say, 75% of completing this automation, and they need help on that last 25% to get it over the goal line, they could have someone to go to or someone to partner with to help them out as they start to learn how to build. So some of the benefits of a co-development model. First, I would say that those who are closest to the problem can be most insightful to the solution. That's a very real point, right? Those who know the business problems the best are going to be the best at being able to solve them. As we start to define automations and as we start to build for those different use cases, we're going to uncover that there's a lot of business processes that either haven't been well documented, aren't documented at all, or are somewhat tribal knowledge, right? It's just this one team does it every day and no one outside that team really knows what it is. That allows us, that co-development model allows us to work with those experts of that business process to make sure that we're able to create that automation. And they do that with the help of having some IT resources that are available to them. So it provides that aid for new developers. And it also is helpful for new opportunity analysis, where we can look at a new opportunity and say, okay, based on that opportunity, we know it's using, you know, Salesforce, it's using Excel, it's using Outlook. Based on those applications, let's determine the most appropriate model for doing co-development. That analysis can be really helpful in taking on new opportunities. But if we look at the anatomy of a co-developed bot, I'm just going to get these three components up here. First is the core, which is the processes and workflow, right? It's the actual thing that we're trying to automate. Outside of that, we have our reusable components, and those may be the packages or the subtasks that we use across multiple bots that allow us to accelerate our bot building. Wrapped around all of that, we have our bot shell. If we break this up to see the anatomy of who's developing this stuff, the citizen developer is primarily responsible for automating the process and the workflow itself, right? Like we said, they're the most familiar with this, so we would expect that they would do most of the development work on that specific process. We would have IT resources who would be primarily responsible for helping out with those reusable packages and subtasks. And then finally, we have the COE-created bot shell. And that bot shell, like we talked about, is the wrapper for everything else that everyone is using for their bot builds. Now, this breakdown here, this anatomy, is not 100% going to be the exact same every single time, right? When we talk about the citizen-developed components, we would say that, you know, okay, maybe the first time they do this, they're only able to do 50% of the process and IT has to help out with the other 50%. But as they continue to upskill and as they continue to build familiarity and comfort with the tool, we should expect that their percentage of development towards an actual opportunity is much higher and they're starting to build more comfort and to the point that they should be able to develop 100% of some bot opportunities on their own. But we need to make sure that we're creating an environment where they feel comfortable and they feel supported as they start to upskill and reskill to learn something that may be completely new for them. And so this is kind of part 2B of our co-development model, which is to develop a heat map based on the applications that your organization is using. And this is really driven by the opportunities that you're looking at for automation. So I would start to develop this heat map to say, okay, on one side, we've got IT-driven bot development. On the other side, we have citizen developer bot driven development. And then on the top, we've got our easy to automate apps. And on the bottom, we have our challenging apps, right? And I would map out all of these applications. And again, this is not set in stone. I expect this to be a living and breathing document that we continue to update as we start to build more comfort with these certain applications. So we might see in the very beginning that, you know, this one internal HR app is really challenging to work with. And we've got some backend monitoring apps that are really tough. But as we start to build more comfort, maybe that's through the creation of packages, maybe that's through us starting to be more comfortable with the way that we interface with those applications or finding new ways to use automation anywhere and take advantage of the inbuilt packages, we might see that those apps start to shift around a little bit. This is super helpful as you start to analyze new opportunities to determine, well, is this a good opportunity for automation anywhere? And if it is, what portion of that should we expect could be developed by our citizen developers versus the portion that we would expect to be developed by our IT developers?